今天的这个事情发生在美国的俄亥俄州，时间是2024年7月12日。有一家体育用品商店拨打了报警电话，说有人在店里盗窃。警察接警后很快就来到了商店。我们先来看看执法记录仪的画面。
Sorry about that. Black pigtails, huge backpack.
What's she covered with?
You know where she went? Thanks, man. I was over here. So when she came in, the backpack was actually open and completely empty. She's mm-hmm. been in the fitting room with Nike and Adidas product. Came out, it's absolutely packed.
Manager's asking for you to go over towards golf. Okay.
Hi. You open up your backpack?
Why?
Because you have items in there that don't belong to you?
That's not true.
Okay, well, open up your backpack.
No, I don't have to do anything for you. I don't even know why you're approaching me. Out of everybody in the store.
我来解释一下这位女士的行为啊。她刚进店的时候，店里的员工就开始观察她了。店员说她背着一个空包，而且是敞开的，但是她拿着一些衣服走进试衣间，然后把衣服全部都装进了自己的包里。她的这种做法实在是太明显，完全没有什么技术含量。现在女士身上背着一个包，手里还提着一个包，我不知道哪一个是她自己背进来的啊，另一个包可能是她拿商店里的，反正现在两个包里都装满了东西。警察找到她的时候，她却装作很无辜的样子。接下来警察决定直接将她逮捕。
When I've been in the dressing room, I've looked at everything that I want to.
Oh, that's right there. All right. We're not going to play that. Just turn around again.
No.
Come
on. Hey, bro, chill.
Stop.
Let you go. Oh, my hair, bro. Stop. I didn't cut anything, bro. Stop.Let me put my shoes on.
Stop.
Bro, let me put my shoes on.
Stop.
Stop. Please let me put my shoes
Stop.
on.
Stop.
Bro, if you keep pushing me, there's no way we...
Stop.
Stop.
Stop now.
Bro, I'm not even allowed to pay for my stuff.
Stop. Stop.
Y'all tripping. I'm trying to pay for my... No.No.
Why did it have to turn into that?
Why did you turn it into that?
You ran from me. Now you're going to go to
jail. Yeah, because you're tripping.
Because you're not going to go to jail.
Why do I got to go to jail?
Because you stole stuff.
I didn't steal anything.
Batman.
I don't say I belong to me.
That all belongs to you?
Yes.
这位女士真的是一派胡言。刚刚在被抓之前，警察问他包里有没有不属于他的东西，他说没有，也不必给警察看，东西都是自己的。但是被抓之后，他却说正要拿这些东西去付款呢，那就是承认包里的东西属于人家商店的呗。而现在他再次改口，又说包里的东西是他自己的，说话前后矛盾啊。包里的东西到底是不是商店里的，打开一看不就知道了。结果当商店员工打开背包的时候，他又说这些东西是他想购买的，只是还没有付款而已。
I've been to the register.
Do you have anything on you that's going to poke me or stick me?
No, sir. Those are what I wanted to pay for. Because it's easier to carry. I don't have a bag.
Yeah, we're good. Yeah.
What the f***?
Let's get it here in the car.
All right.
Can I get my shoes? One shoe is right there. Can I get it?
We'll get it for you, no.
It's right there. Where's the other one?
I don't know. You might.
Yeah, because you're tripping. You instantly came up to me and started harassing me. No, they didn't.
Where's your other shoe at?
I'm looking.
I see it. Why did it have to turn into that?
That's what I want to know.
You were going to go home with a summons.
Okay.
You're gonna get a summons for all this.
That'd have been fine.
But if it's over $1,000, I guess it might be a felony.
It's not over $1,000.
How much is in there?
I don't know.
What, she had another bag? Oh, that bag.
Yeah, this had the Timberlands in it, ton of hats. I'll have to take a look at that one.
We'll probably have to go with just what she had on her. Did she have that in her hand? Why did that have to happen?
I don't know. Why did you force it?
Come on.
So you're going to steal and then act like it's my fault? Should I just let you steal and walk out of here with a bunch of stuff?
Who said I was walking out with it?
It was in your book bag.
And my wallet is right there. You don't know what was going on. Can I just get a summons? I'm tired
of it. No, not
that. What do you mean?
What do you mean?
Why you can't just give me a summons? You're tasty. I don't though. If you check, I promise you it's not.
I don't know. Dick's is pretty expensive.
I'm telling you, I don't have over $1,000 worth of stuff. You can check. And if you check, can I please get a summons?
No.
Why not?
If you were a cooperative from the very beginning, yes, maybe.
But you didn't give me a chance to. You instantly started harassing me.
I asked you to open your bag because it's full of stuff that you didn't come in with.
You opened your bag
and then it would have been it. You would have got a summons. I guarantee you. If you would have been cooperative with me,
I can't afford to do this. My mom just. My birthday. I'm just trying to make it ends meet.
Get your feet in.
Please, sir.
We'll talk about it. Get your feet in, okay?
Will you please? You'll talk to me with it?
We'll talk about it in a second, but you gotta get your feet in.
I'll do that. But please, sir. I'm having a hard time.
女士被逮捕了，警察再回头跟商店员工确认一下所发生的事情啊。员工说，其实在报警之前就已经发现女士的偷窃行为了。她把衣服拿进试衣间，然后塞进了背包里。她刚从试衣间出来，员工准备拦住她，但是女士突然间就逃跑了。不过她并没有跑出商店啊，而是继续在商店里逛。真不知道她是怎么想的。后来女士也承认了自己的偷窃行为，她说自己没有钱来付房租，想拿这些衣服来抵房租。商店员工把女士所偷的东西统计过了，一共是1019.97美元。不过女士除了今天的偷窃行为以外，她之前还有一张逮捕令。
But the problem is you have another resisting arrest warrant.
What are you talking about? A warrant?
Yes, you have a warrant for resisting.
For what?
For resisting arrest.
Where? You said what?
Resisting arrest.
For where?
Hold on a second.
Because I didn't resist arrest on anything. Can you please tell me where it's at?
Is this your car over here?
Yes, sir. I really don't understand why I have a warrant. My 3-0 told me I don't have any warrants. Why do I have a warrant for? I've been to jail every time they took me. I've never not got away. And I promise you that. There should not be any warrant. But sir, there should be no warrant for me.I shouldn't have a warrant. I haven't done anything. The last time I got arrested, they took me both to Summit Jail and to Canton.
You must have missed the court date.
女士都已经不记得自己有张逮捕令了，看来她也没有少进监狱啊。问题是她经常进监狱，那么为什么却没有改造好呢？出来之后继续犯事，就不能好好生活吗？希望她这次进去以后能够好好反思自己的错误。最后女士被指控拒捕和入店行窃，女士所偷窃的金额为1019.97美元。根据俄亥俄州的法律规定，盗窃金额低于1000美元的属于一级轻罪，可被判处180天的监禁和最高1000美元的罚款，而盗窃金额在1000美元到7500美元之间的构成五级重罪，可能会在监狱服刑6个月到1年，并且必须支付2500美元的罚款。女士今天的行为就属于五级重罪啊。另外说一个题外话，经常有朋友会说美国的零元购不是合法了吗？这种说法就是胡说啊。有的州规定盗窃金额在某个标准以下的属于轻罪，但轻罪也是犯罪啊，只是可能会被判得轻一点，从来没有偷窃合法这一说啊。总之偷人家的东西就是不对的。好了，本期的视频就到这里了，感谢观看。